Hello everyone, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will learn about secondary structure of the protein. So the learning objectives will be to explain the secondary structure of the protein and to give examples for the secondary structure of the protein. Now, we learned that primary structure of the protein was just a linear sequence of amino acids. Now, how this linear sequence of amino acid gets folded to form secondary structure is what we will learn now. So, the secondary structure is the arrangement of amino acids in space. How the atoms present inside the amino acids are arranged, they arrange themselves in spatial. So, see. These are the amino acids A1, A2, A3, A4. All these amino acids are linear. So this is a primary structure. Now this primary structure gets folded to form the secondary structure. This secondary structure, apart from peptide bond, has hydrogen bond. Now the hydrogen bond can be intramolecular, which means within the molecule, and intermolecular, which means between two molecules. Because of the hydrogen bonding, there is a folding which occurs. Now, why does the folding occur? This folding is because of interactions of the amino acid side chains. Now, we said that the amino acids have a variable R chain. And because of this variable R chain, there are 20 types of amino acids. All these amino acids have different nature. And because of this nature, they interact with each other, form bondings. And these bondings result in different types of structures. So, Linus Pauling and Michael Corey were the scientists who in 1951 demonstrated that secondary structure can be basically of two types, the alpha helix and the beta pleated sheet, as you can see in the diagram. So, this is the primary structure, that is a linear structure. Now, it has undergone different types of foldings to form the secondary structure. So, this is the alpha helix and this is the beta pleated sheet. Let us discuss them individually. So first, alpha helix. The alpha helix is like a spiral. Just imagine a coil, a spring, right? So it is in the form of a spring. How this spring is formed? It is because of the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So this intramolecular hydrogen bonding, how does it occur? It occurs between the carbonyl group of one amino acid and the amide group of another amino acid, which is 4 down the first amino acid. So, after every 4 amino acids, there will be a hydrogen bonding. This is, therefore, it is known as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So, the bonding is between nth and n minus 4th amino acid. Now, each turn of the helix contains around 3.6 amino acids. Why 3.6 amino acids? Which means 3 amino acids are complete in one turn and there is a 1 amino acid of which 0.6 part is in one turn and 0.4 part is in another turn. Now, this alpha helix, because it is spirally coiled, it is very, very strong. Now, where is the alpha helix found in our body? It is found in keratin. The keratin protein, which is present in nails, toenails, hair, claws, everywhere, it is very hard protein, which has alpha helix secondary structure. Next is the beta pleated structure. So the beta pleated structure means it should be like pleats. So beta pleated structure, two or more segments of polypeptide chain, they interact with each other. Now they can be segment of the same polypeptide chain, or they can be two different polypeptide chains also. They are shown in the form of arrows. So, like this, you show, this is the way you show a beta structure. This is how they are linked. Now, the beta structure has hydrogen bonding between same types of groups, the carbonyl and the amide group. As you can see, this is the amide group, this is the carbonyl group. But these carbonyl groups and amide groups are of different polypeptide chains. See in the diagram, this is one polypeptide chain, this is another polypeptide chain. They can be segments also. So the bonding is intermolecular. It is between two segments or two polypeptides. So it is known as intermolecular. Therefore, we can see the clear difference in alpha helix and beta pleated structure. In alpha helix, it was intramolecular. Here it is intermolecular. So the beta helix also has R groups. In beta helix, the R groups are above and below the plane. Let us see in the diagram. So in the alpha helix, what will happen? The R groups will lie outside. They will not lie inside the helix. Inside the helix will only be hydrogen bonding. But in beta pleated structures, what will happen? They will be lying above or below the plane. These R groups, they will not interact. They will not participate in hydrogen bonding, but they will lie outside the plane. So they are shown by flattened arrows. And where are they found? They are found in fibroin of silks and feathers of the birds. So beta pleated structures and alpha helix, both of them are very, very strong structures. To summarize, we can say that secondary structure is a three-dimensional spatial arrangement of atoms in the primary structure. It shows how the primary structure folds. The secondary structure occurs because of the hydrogen bonding apart from the peptide bond. And the hydrogen bonding can be intramolecular as in case of alpha helix and intermolecular as in case of beta pleated sheets. And both the structures are very strong. Alpha helix is found in the nails and claws and beta pleated structure is found in fibroin of silk. So this was all about secondary structure. Now we will move to tertiary structure. Till then, thank you very much.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.